In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor like this one that is able to trade the Bollinger Band signal, and it also uses the RSI oscillator as a filter. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the meter editor window, and here we have a pre-coded version for the Bollinger Band's RSI expert advisor. The first thing we do is to use the include function to include the file trade.mqh. This one comes with MQL5 and it provides some simplified trading functions. And we also use include to include two more modules that we are going to create later on. The first one is to check the entry for the Bollinger Bands. And the second one is for the RSI oscillator. We start by calculating the ask price and the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double for the current symbol on the chart. We either use symbol underscore ask or symbol underscore bid. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we make sure to calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. That is depending on the currency pair we use. Now we use ctrade to create an instance called trade that will be used to open the trades later on. And we create an array called price info by using MQL rates. We do that outside of the untick function because we need the same thing here in the Bollinger Bands module. And in the untick function, we start with array set as series to sort our price info array from the current candle downwards. Then we can use copy rates to fill our price info array for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart, starting from candle 0 for 3 candles. And to calculate the current price, we look into the price info array, especially at candle 0 and at close price. Now let's find out how to get the trading signal. That can be done by using a function called check entry Bollinger. And this function exists in this module here. It is called check entry Bollinger and it will give back a string value to our main module. We start by creating a string variable for the signal. Now we create 3 arrays for the middle, the upper and the lower band array. And we sort all 3 arrays by using array set series. Afterwards, we use the built-in IBANs function of MQL5 for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on the chart. We want to calculate the values for 20 candles. No shift value and the deviation value is 2. The results will be calculated based on the close price. Let's continue to fill our arrays with copy buffer. According to the Bollinger Bands definition that we have created above, we are going to do that for buffer 0, that's the middle band array, buffer 1 for the upper band array, and buffer 2 for the lower band array. All 3 values are starting from candle 0, that's the current candle, and we want to copy the values for 3 candles and store them in the according arrays. That makes it possible to get the current values for the middle band, the upper band and the lower band by looking at candle 0 in the according arrays. That will give us the price for the current candle, and we do that again for candle 1. That's the candle before the current one. And if the close price for candle 1 of our price info array was below the lower Bollinger band, and if it is now above the lower Bollinger band, that would mean we have a buy signal. In the other case, if the close price for candle 1 was above the upper band, and if it is now below the upper band for candle 0, that would mean we have a sell signal, and that's when we assign the word sell to our signal. And finally, we return our signal to the main module, and that's where we check the filter by using a function check entry RSI. We can find that one in the second module. It is called check entry RSI and it returns a string value. Once again, we create a signal. And we need to create an array for the RSI. And then we can use the built-in IRSI function for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart to calculate the value for 14 candles based on the close price. Let's also sort this array by using array set as series. And with copy buffer, we fill our RSI array according to the definition that we have created here for buffer 0, starting from the current candle 0 for 3 candles. And that makes it possible to get the current RSI value by looking at candle 0 in our array. And with normalize double and the last parameter here, we make the output having 2 digits behind the dot, because that is how the RSI value looks like on the chart. Now, if the RSI value is above 70, that would mean we have a sell signal. And if the RSI value is below 30, we consider that to be a buy signal. So finally, we return the signal to our main module. And here we can check if the trading signal equals buy and if the filter also equals buy. And when these conditions are true and positions total returns a value of 0, that means we have a buy signal for the filter and for the signal, and we have no open trades. And that's when we use trade.buy to open a buy trade for 10 microlot. In the other case, if the trading signal equals sell, and if the filter also equals sell, and we have no open positions, we use trade.sell to sell 10 microlot. Finally, we use the comment statement to output the trading signal and to output the filter directly on our chart. So far, so good. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here does, you maybe want to watch one of the other basic videos in this video series. And on our website, you can find the premium course that might be interesting for you. Or maybe you want to download some of the source codes here from our store, so you don't have to type everything. But for now, we click on the compile button or press F7 on our keyboard. That worked without any errors here. And if that is the case, you can click on a little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. This brings up the Strategy Tester panel here. Please mark the visual mode option. Select the file standalone Bollinger RSI.ex5 and start your test. Here is our little expert advisor at work. Now we should see a signal in a few seconds. And as soon as the signal and the filter point into the right direction, we have the first trade. So our little expert advisor works as designed. And in this little video, you have learned how to create an expert advisor for the Bollinger Bands and the RSI. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.